what you see here is form how I will put the braces on this guitar. So these are fan braces. It's like a fan, so they call it fan braces. And these are transfer braces. So this is a brace that goes from one side of the guitar to the other side. And under those braces are these transfer braces. This is one transfer brace, and this is one transfer brace. They go under a piece of brace that's glued in like this. What we do now, all these braces are sawn on a particular way, and it's called quarter sawn. That's better. So you can see the lines of the rings of the tree, grow rings, and you have to saw these rings, or you have to saw this wood on a quarter sawn base. This is how it's quarter sawn. So we give it a dome shape. So that's for strength and also for beauty a bit. So to sand this in a better form, I made a convex shape in a sanding block. So I'll use 240 grit to start with, and then end with 320 or 380. So I made a back rest for this piece, because these pieces are flexible and I want to have total control when I glue this on, so that it stays in place. These tapes are from protection of the underside, so that the top won't get damaged. Put some glue on. to the metal part. It has to be straight, because there are some patches here that are exactly straight for the neck piece where the top will be glued on. So you have to be very, very careful that it is straight. And always clamp from the inside out, so that the glue can go to the sides. More clamps, more clamps. You can't have enough clamps. Always a shortage on clamps. Do I have more? I thought I had more. Oh yeah, here's one. But these clamps will cost you. It's like 25 euros a clamp, so that's a lot. So 150 euros on the long clamps. The shorter ones are a little bit less expensive, but still a lot. Now you can put some pressure on it. Clamps here did the best. Nice and straight. So we'll get back when the glue is 10 minutes on. As you can see, these braces go under these cross braces. There will be an opening in this, but that would weaken the wood here. So this one is going here under this bridge, and I'll reinforce it with a piece of 1.5 millimeter. This is a piece of mahogany, and I'll strengthen it, and I'll show it later. It goes underneath the bridge, just here, and here is another cross one, and it strengthens this piece. So I'll glue this in first, and then later I'll go and model the bridge, and this one goes under. So that's what I'm going to do now. I'll make a tick mark here. And this is a mark. I'll cut it with a chisel. So this piece will go in here. Fold it back with a piece of glue in here. Very little glue, doesn't need much. Just put it on there and glue it straight on. In about 10 minutes I'll remove tape carefully and remove the excess of glue. Now put the second one in. These pieces of wood, these bits, come from the same patch as the underside of the bridge. So I put them on a vise like this. Like this. I'll take this piece. I already made it more or less to the right shape. I'll put it in place very carefully, and then I'll make a mark here, make a mark here, here, and here, where it touches the bridge. Now I'm gonna connect these marks with my knife. I'll put it upside down to this straight edge. This is a piece of straight metal. I'll clamp it down. I'll put it on here. And then tighten the vise. And the piece that sticks out can be cut away because this is the same height. But always use a file with a safe edge. I filed it away. A safe edge is like this. This will file this piece away. So you need a safe edge to do that. And then on this part too. So, that's it. That should fit nicely.